In today's tutorial, I will show you how to create this disintegrating animation in Cinema 4D. Let's begin. For this tutorial, I will be using this model. To break our model, we will need the Voronoi Fracture tool. Navigate to the Cloner menu and select Voronoi Fracture. Now drag your 3D model into the Voronoi Fracture layer. You should see your model split into different colored shapes. If you want to increase the number of shapes in which your model will be split, select the Voronoi Fracture layer, and under Sources, choose the Point Generator Distribution layer. A menu will appear. Find the Point Amount section and increase it to your preferred amount. I will set mine to 2000. Now to break them into pieces, we will need an effector. So go ahead to the MoGraph menu and under Effector, select Plane. This will automatically move your model upward. Don't worry, we will fix that. Head over to the Planes Parameter tab and deactivate the position box. Your model will return back to its original position. What we want is to activate the scale box, so select it. I want the scale to be uniform, so select the uniform scale box. And for scale value, I want it to be -1, because once the pieces break, I want them to disappear. Press return, and well, it disappeared. Don't worry, we will get it back. Head over to the Fall Off tab and in Linear Field, we are going to select Linear Field. You will now see our model shatter into pieces. If we move the Linear Field, you can see how that affects the disintegration. I want the Linear Field to be tighter, so I will select this point here and reduce the length. You can also change the length by moving this bar. Okay, I want to reduce it a bit more. Okay, this looks about right. It's time to animate the disintegration. Select your Linear Field layer. I'll position it where I want it to begin. This looks good. Make sure you are at the beginning of your timeline and add a keyframe. Now drag the marker to the end of your timeline. Move the Linear Field to where you want it to end and add another keyframe. Perfect. Now let's preview it. This looks good. But what if I want the particles to float outward and not just stay in position? For that, go ahead and select your Voronoi Fracture layer. And then go to the MoGraph menu. Under Effector, go ahead and select Random. Our model looks chaotic. That's because we need to change some settings from our random effector. Under its Parameter tab, I want the position X and Y to be 100. And the position C to be 150. Now, when I drag my Linear Field, nothing happens. I don't see the model. That's because we need to go back to our Random Effector tab, and where it says Strength, reduce it back to 0. You should now be able to see your model. But when we preview it, nothing changed. That's because we need to animate our Random Effector. Make sure you are at the beginning of your timeline and add a keyframe to the strength. Now move to the end of your timeline and increase the value to your strength to 100 and add a keyframe. When we preview it, we see that it kind of does what I want. I want the pieces to break apart at the same time our linear effector passes through our model, and not sooner. We can see that random effector takes effect immediately. To fix that, go and select your random effector layer. Select the falloff tab and drag in the linear field we use for our plane effector inside the random effectors field. Perfect! You should now see the random effector take place the same time as the plane effector. This looks good. But what if I want to animate my duck? I want him to react to what's happening around him. So I am going to select the Voronoi fracture layer. I'll make sure I am at the beginning of my timeline. And I'll add a keyframe. Around here, I want my duck to turn around to see what's happening. I'll add another keyframe. I'll now go to the end of my timeline and have my duck turn around and try to run away. Not that far, but somewhere here. This looks good. I'll add a keyframe here. Now, when I preview it, it kind of looks good. But around here, I want the duck to have a complete turnaround. I'll select my Voronoi fracture layer again. I'll rotate the duck and then I'll add a keyframe. This looks good. Now when I preview it again, it looks amazing. And there you have it. You now know how to create this disintegrating animation in Cinema 4D. If you would like to download this project file, head over to the Tutu's Gumroad page. You can find the link in the description of this video. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.